All right, so you're trying to figure out what's the difference between a flash drive, a hard drive, a solid state drive, and then you just get so confused and you don't know what is what. But that's why you got tech people like me so the geek side can come out. Now, before we get started, I know I'm gonna have those people who love to put in the comments, hey, what's the true definition of a hard drive? What's the true definition of a solid state drive? Or hey, you said this incorrect. Whatever it is, I'm going to make sure that in this video, I break that down for you. So, let me pull this out just so you can get the verbatim Wikipedia definition of what a hard drive is. A hard disk drive is So now you're asking, which one should I go with? It all depends on what you're using them for. My MacBook is a 512 gig SSD hard drive, but to go up to a terabyte hard drive was almost $600 or $700. So instead, I paid $149 for this, and it's 4 terabytes of storage, and it has USB 3.0. I also paid $149 for this SSD 512 gigabyte hard drive that has USB 3.1. So again, you just have to decide which one's better for you when it comes to price points. If you're a gamer, a lot that you need to store, definitely go with a bigger hard drive. Again, this says for PlayStation 4, but you can utilize this as a backup hard drive in any capacity. The big differences between the two, this has moving parts, which means that if you drop this, this is more susceptible to breaking than this is because it doesn't have any moving parts. This right here also makes noise. It's really light, but you can still hear when it comes on. This right here doesn't make any noise. So again, you have to take those things into consideration when you're going out to buy these. Okay, so real quick, just so you can get an insight on how fast these really are, we're gonna start with the Passport, which is the regular hard drive, and see how long it takes for it to load and be operable on the computer. Right there, you can see it took 11.2 seconds. Now let's try the SSD hard drive and see how long that takes. The SSD hard drive took 7 seconds, which is 4 seconds faster. I keep this particular device because I have my MacBook backed up on this in case something happened. Now, with those things to consider and the pros and the cons on all of them, you decide which one's a better point for you. The $149 Western Digital 4 terabyte hard drive or the Lexar 512 gigabyte solid state drive. So in conclusion, you're really asking yourself, which one should I get? I'm gonna put a checklist here so you can look at that checklist and you can see what might be a better fit for you. Again, at the end of the day, the big difference is the solid state drives don't have any moving parts, making them more durable, less noisy, and faster. If you're looking for a lot of storage space on the inexpensive route, go ahead and look at the hard drive over the solid state drive. Now, if you like these videos, make sure you hit that thumbs up button. And while you're down there, hit that subscribe button. The more people that know about this channel, the better decision people can make before they go out and buy these products. Again, this has been another production from OndaWire. I'm out.